From living under the shadow of Lisa and Lenny's stardom to her continuous struggle with an eating disorder. These are some secrets that Zoe Kravitz fans never knew. To start off, we've got her struggles with having famous parents. When we imagine the lives of star kids, it's easy to think that they have it all. But hearing about Zoe's experience of growing up with all that limelight and the constant pressure of expectations really makes you question that. On December 1st, 1988, actress Lisa Bonet and Grammy-winning singer Lenny Kravitz were blessed with a little girl who the world now knows as Catwoman. Now let's keep in mind that Lisa was already at the height of fame because of her role as Denise Huxtable in the sitcom The Cosby Show. And in case any of you Gen Z kids don't know this, The Cosby Show was literally that one show everyone would watch. And if being the daughter of a well-known actress wasn't enough attention, even her father was starting to become a big name in the music industry. In fact, just a year after Zoe's birth, Lenny released his debut album, Let Love Rule, which was a huge hit in Europe. Now, imagine being the daughter of a literal rock star and the queen of so many hearts. Zoe already had quite a lot to live up to, even as a kid. But her childhood became even more difficult after her parents split when she was 5. Lenny and Lisa really didn't do the whole marriage planning thing, or maybe they did, and somehow thought they were ready to have a kid just 1 year into the marriage. Because the couple got married in 1987, and then the following year, Zoe was born. But just 5 years later, in 1993, Zoe's parents decided to part ways, and the Batman fame actress was forced to choose between her mother and her father. Apparently, Lenny's reason for filing for divorce was that he felt like he just wasn't ready. But he stayed good friends with his wife Lisa, and they did their best to co-parent Zoe even though she ended up living with her mother. That's right, Zoe didn't have a consistent father figure living with her when she was younger. Then again, growing up with divorced parents is never easy. But if you're surprised to learn about her struggles as a child, wait till you hear about how Zoe made it big in the industry. Did you know the 34-year-old chose not to have a college degree? Instead, she jumped straight into the industry, and she was only 18 at that time. The story goes that the actress started studying at an acting school under Scott McRae right after she graduated high school. She soon realized that this was what she was born to do, so she quit college within a year and moved to Brooklyn. But if you think that the road was easy for her from day one, you're sorely mistaken. Kravitz had to struggle quite a bit in her early days. Her first film was the 2007 rom-com No Reservations, directed by Scott Hicks, and Zoe was cast in a supporting role. This was her big debut, but it was lukewarm at best, and Zoe didn't get much of the limelight anyway, but people did take notice of her acting skills when she played a sex worker in a thriller called The Brave One, which was released in the same year. After that, she did a whole lot of side roles in mid-films before she finally got her big break in X-Men because of her role as Angel Salvador. But her true potential as an actor was finally recognized when she started playing the role of Bonnie Carlson on the hit HBO drama series Big Little Lies. And she was working alongside a dream cast of really hot, powerful women, including Nicole Kidman and Reese Witherspoon. It was at this point that she was nominated for multiple awards for her brilliant performance on TV, and that's when Zoe struck gold. The rest is history, because Zoe is now slowly becoming a household name, especially after the whopping success of Batman. And let's be real, she deserved that acclaim because she worked damn hard for that role. The actress literally watched cat videos to train as Catwoman. Everyone has been gushing about Zoe's performance as Selina Kyle opposite Robert Pattinson in The Batman, but not everyone knows just how hard the actress worked to transform into the character. She literally watched tons of videos of big cats out and about in the wilderness so that she could copy their style of walking. Apparently, the actress wanted to have the same fluid and sly body language that cats do. Now, that's commitment. To top all of this, she also had to follow a strict diet and workout routine so that she could look slim and strong for her role. And even though there was a 6-month hiatus during the shoot thanks to COVID, this dedicated lady made sure that she remained well in shape for whenever the shoot would begin again. Impressive, right? But acting isn't her only skill. Fans have no idea how multi-talented this woman is. People get to hear about her acting career all the time. But little does the world know that Zoe is also a director and is currently working on her directorial debut, starring the handsome Channing Tatum. The movie is literally called Pussy Island and is Zoe's hot take on the Me Too movement. But the list of her talents doesn't stop here. It turns out this little diva is also a singer. Looks like someone takes after both their parents. And if you're surprised to hear this, wait till you find out that she's working on a solo album with Jack Antonoff, who has previously collaborated with the infamous Taylor Swift. Oh, and Zoe already has some musical experience in her bag, as she was part of a band called Lola Wolf. And that's not even everything. Zoe is also a model and is the literal face of French fashion house, Saint Laurent. But the sad part is that even though she has insane talent, Zoe Kravitz has been a victim of racism. Now, not a lot of people know this, but The Batman wasn't Zoe's first attempt at bagging a role in the franchise. She actually auditioned for a role in The Dark Knight 2. This was back in 2012, but things didn't really turn out in her favor. When speaking to The Observer, Zoe revealed that she never got a call back from the team. They told her that they didn't want to cast her because she was too urban for the film. Jeez. We all know what that means. It must have been very satisfying for her to finally get cast as Catwoman. But unfortunately, this wasn't the first time she experienced casual racism. Zoe has opened up about how hard it was for her to fit into white suburban neighborhoods, especially when she was shooting Big Little Lies in California, where she encountered a whole lot of weird racist people in the bars. But if you think racism was the only struggle in her life, wait till you hear about Zoe Kravitz's crazy love life. The actress has always been private about her romances, but Zoe and her current boyfriend, Mr. Channing Tatum, actually go way back. They first connected in 2017, after Zoe pitched her Pussy Island script to him, but then they lost touch for a couple of years, before fate brought them together again and they started working on their dream project with each other. Apparently, Tatum was a real gentleman throughout. He would often make her tea and take care of her during the shoot. No wonder she fell in love. And the couple became official in 2021. But did you know that Zoe was married before this too? She was married to Carl Glusman back in 2019, but their marriage barely lasted a year, and she divorced him for pretty much the same reasons her parents divorced. Kravitz usually stays quiet about this relationship, mostly because it's a sensitive subject for her. She had known the man for 4 years after all, but it looks like the X-Men actress still needed to recover from her childhood trauma, and that included Zoe's continuous struggle with an eating disorder. When speaking to The Observer, she opened up about her self-esteem issues as a teen. Turns out Zoe really hated her hair because it wasn't straight. And at certain points in her life, she grew tired of being black. Yikes. She probably had to deal with a lot for her to feel this way about her skin color. After all, it's difficult being black in the film industry, even in 2023. But all this, along with the pressure of being perfect because of her parents' fame, made the poor girl develop an eating disorder during her youth. You heard it right. The 34-year-old was bulimic throughout most of her teenage years. And even stepping into the role of Catwoman was really scary for her because there was a chance of relapse, especially since she had to slim down quite a lot for the role. But the good news is Zoe has managed to find a middle ground and is making progress with her mental health. So, from Zoe's continuous struggle with an eating disorder to her growing up under the shadow of Lisa and Lenny's stardom, these are secrets that Zoe Kravitz fans never knew.